Who gives this bride away?
Her brother, her mother, and I do. Good luck, man. She's a handful.
The bride wishes you to be seated. We are here this afternoon to formalize and celebrate the joining of Jackson and Brooke in marriage. And Brooke, all I can say is, wow, you look incredible. Jackson, would you concur?
Absolutely.
Marriage was not man's idea, but God's. It's not a contract, but a covenant. This is holy before the Lord.
And in the first marriage, God presented Eve to Adam in the same way that Brooke has been presented to you today, Jackson. And in Genesis chapter 2, verses 23 and 24, it records that Adam said, "This is now bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman because she was taken out of man." This is why a man leaves his father and mother and is united to his wife, and they become one flesh. Now, this is not just a physical union, but a growing in oneness in every aspect of your lives. God created marriage so that two people can grow in mental, emotional, and spiritual oneness as well. Remember well that marriage is not a competition, but a complement. You both have differences of opinion, how you see the world, different talents and different abilities, and it's very easy to let these differences cause strife and division. But the key to peace and unity in the home is found in the words of Jesus. The greatest love possible is shown when you lay down your life for your friends. And while, yes, I'm sure at the drop of a hat you'd be willing to take a bullet for Brooke, it means much more than laying down your physical life. As you lay down your selfishness, you can achieve the goal of marriage, which is not to win, but to be one. To grow in intimacy and unity. And so now, Jackson, you are to be united with Brooke before God. She is to take priority in your life, second only to Jesus. You are now the head of your home with her and the priest of your family. And this means that it's primarily your responsibility to cultivate the culture and spiritual climate of your home.
And Brooke, standing here beside Jackson, you're taking a stand with him. You're coming under Jackson's headship and standing at his side as a support, as a running mate. He is to take priority in all your life above every relationship, second only to Christ.
And so now we have some important questions to ask. Jackson, do you take Brooke to be your wife? To live together? Well, wait.
Hold on. Hold on.
To live with her together in holy marriage. Will you love her, comfort her, honor her, and keep her in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, and to be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
Brooke, do you take Jackson to be your husband, to live together in holy marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
I do.
The wedding ring. The wedding ring is a symbol of a perfect circle. It's a circle with no end. And in the same way, your love should have no end, and grow deeper and deeper every day. The ring is made out of a precious metal, just as your marriage is perfect and precious. The ring is made so that you always know that you have a home.
And now, Jackson, as the head of your home, we are going to start with you. If you will take the ring and place it upon Brooke's finger and repeat after me. This ring is a symbol of my love.
This ring is a symbol of my love.
And commitment to you as long as I live.
Commitment to you.
You got it.
As long as I live.
It will be a constant reminder of our vows. I am honored to call you my wife.
I am honored to call you my wife.
Brooke, repeat after me. This ring is a symbol of my love.
This ring is a symbol of my love.
And commitment to you as I live.
And commitment to you as I live.
It will be a constant reminder of our vows.
It will be a constant reminder of our vows.
I am honored to call you my husband.
I am honored to call you my husband.
And now Jackson and Brooke have wished to seal their vows to one another with the symbolic act of braiding three strands into a cross. Ecclesiastes chapter 4, verse 12 says, a cord of three strands is not easily broken. Even so, as Jesus remains at the center of their marriage, it will be able to withstand anything that life throws at them.
And now, before God and all those gathered here, it is our greatest pleasure to pronounce you husband and wife.
Jackson.
Hold on. Wow, these two, you guys.
Made us wait 24 hours.
All right.
We're waiting. Jackson, you may now kiss your bride.
We are delighted to present to you
Mr. and Mrs. Hamlet.